I want to talk to you about your line of underwear, Frigo Crown. These are $150 pairs of underwear.
See, and you see how you said that? Now felt extreme for a man.
Yeah.
How much can you buy underwear for a woman?
That's true. It's pretty
expensive.
You can
buy it instead of cars, you can buy underwear.
Right, yeah. So this is finally a man has a way to splash some money out for his undergarments.
Old woman has a way to splash some of his money out for him.
So this is what you would recommend. This is a good Christmas present, then.
It is, exactly.
And what are the times where you would wear the Frigos?
You should be past the I'm not sure this is going to happen stage into the I'm almost certain tonight.
I see. Don't waste these on a night where the next time your pants come off,
not
it's at your house.
Night, and she sees you when you bent over. You wear those all the time type
of
thing.
Yeah, so these are the special ones.
Yeah, these are special. Look what I got for you, girl.
And they're, I get it. Look, this one's got a lion. I don't know if people can tell that's a lion with a crown on it. That is
crown. That's right. I use the hierarchy of living for the design inspiration.
And you actually... you model these, and you were on the cover of Muscle and Fitness. This is the first look.
Yeah, it's exclusive.
So you obviously got in shape for, I mean, you're in shape, but this is, I mean, just bravo. I mean, I wouldn't call him boo-boo. I would imagine, though, as you're talking about this underwear, it must be a little tricky because you've had all these other jobs. You've been an actor. You've been a producer. But when you talk about underwear, certainly on TV, there's a lot of words you can't use.
Yeah. Like, look, I say, like, man apples or, like...
Yep.
The plums.
The plums?
Because you said, look, you say genitals or you say balls, and women start to go, like, can you just say that? Like, why did you have to say that way? Your tone of voice was off or something.
But they are okay. Women are okay with plums?
A little better.
Yeah.
They're going, well, wait, what is he talking about? Mm. That split second that they don't know exactly what you're talking about saves you.
You come home with a girl and she says, I want to go to the farmer's market.
And you go.
So, we had, Gayle King was on the show last night, and I heard, is this true, that you had a dog named Oprah and a cat named Gayle?
Yeah.
So you were obviously a fan of Oprah and Gayle.
Well, you know, at first I didn't like her, because every time Oprah would make reference to what was wrong with hip-hop culture, was something that was, like, on my CD. It was, like, the largest debut in hip-hop album. I said, I'm never gonna go there. Like, she's never gonna have me on her couch. So I was like... If we can't be friends, at least let's be enemies.
Sure, exactly. That's the second one.
You know, so sort of the fans don't feel like you're less than for not being able to be there when the A-listers are.
Right, of course.
You know, so when we did come around finally and I was on the show, I was like, hey, you know, all the stuff I was saying, I didn't mean that stuff. you know.
And so you got on well when you met. And you guys are in a good place right now. You're over.
I met Gayle at, strange enough, I met her through Bette Midler.
So you met, I would not have guessed that.
Yeah.
And how did 50 Cent meet Gayle? Bette Midler would have been my millionth choice. Well,
yeah. her organization, NYPR, like, they kind of are responsible for all the green in the city.
Right.
So I redid a park in my neighborhood, and because I did it, she had me come to, like, a banquet. And it was really interesting, because they gave me tables for free, but the tables were, like, really expensive.
They are at those charity
events.
At
the banquet, like, you'd be there, like, how much? And then she had a spotlight. She knew what she was doing. Like, they had a spotlight. Boom, like a big bat light. And it was like, so how many cherry trees are you going to buy?
Right.
And then the cherry trees are like $2,500 a piece. I'm like, wait, I want to know where my trees are so I can go carve my name in each one of these.
Yeah. I'll give you a cherry. Yeah. And then did you tell Gayle? Does Gayle know that you have a feline Gayle in your home?
Well, yeah, she had already heard.
Okay. And was she happy? Did she take it as a compliment?
Well, no, but she was like, well, what is he doing here? Like, when Beth
said, when she saw you at the...
I was like, well, what is he doing here? Like, you know, like a gangster rapper at the banquet for trees.
Yeah. And then she found out you built a park, and she was probably pretty happy.
She was like, oh, he built a park. So what else don't I know about him?
There you go.
And then this is what opened the doors for the communications between me and Oprah, because she went back and she told her.
Well, that's great.
Like.
Well, everything comes full circle. Well, it's always so wonderful to have you here. Can I keep these as a Christmas present for myself?
Yeah, you're supposed to use those.
Okay, I'm going to use them.
When you feel like something's going to happen.
Okay, great. I might like call you and say, all right, 50, here's how the night's going. Does it sound good?
Listen. I think she's ready.
Curtis, 50 Cent Jackson, everybody. Free go down on the garden is available through iWear Free. FRIGO.com and at Neiman Marcus starting in December.